She was little. Well, she was, yeah.
Eleanor.
Mom said, okay.
Salud.
We went to college together.
This is where I'm representing. Nothing for California.
Oh, good. That'll bring us back.
Yes. It's so much
Oh, no, Jeffrey doesn't have one.
It's so much warmer there.
Yeah,
it's snowing there.
I'm still in California.
It's so much warmer.
Alice. Mama to Jennifer.
Mother.
Susanna.
This is my sister.
Her sister.
La hermana.
La hermana de.
La tía.
Yeah.
Okay.
Me llamo Catherine.
Serena. Es la amiga de Jennifer de college.
Y Catherine.
Oye, pues.
Y ella también.
This is Eleanor, my daughter.
She's so cute.
How old is she? She's 7 months.
It's more natural when it's crooked.
Yeah, maybe next time you can try.
It is easier.
Another one.
Jennifer, thanks for coming all the way from Virginia for the shower. I know it took a little convincing to convince you that a bridal shower was something that you wanted to do. I hope that you're having a good time, and we're really looking forward to the wedding as well.
We're so excited for the wedding.
For the wedding. Excited for see to Michael.
Yeah.
I don't see for a long time. My grandson. Yeah. And this is, I'm so happy.
Yeah, we're so happy that they're happy,
yeah.
Right? You're happy that they're happy?
Yeah.
Very excited.
I have.
What do you think about?
I like it to come in today.
Yeah, you like. What do you think about Jen? You like Jen?
Yeah.
Jen's really nice, right?
Again. You okay?
Yeah. All right, Jennifer, we wish you the best and a long, happy marriage and much success. And hopefully you guys will get back to the West Coast.
And babies, and definitely West Coast.
Yeah. Babies are always good, yeah.
Hello, congratulations. I'm super excited for your big day.
Hi, I'm really excited for your wedding and all the happiness that awaits you. And I'm really happy that you found Michael and you two are going to live happily ever after. Just very happy for you.
Congratulations, Jen. I don't know. Like, I'm really happy that you're part of our family right now. And I'm so excited for the wedding.
We are Jennifer's auntie, eldest auntie. I congratulate Jennifer and Michael. I'm very happy for them. Congratulations again.
Jonathan and Michael, I'm so happy for both of you to have the wedding soon. And today I'm so happy. Everything is so good. The hosting is very special. So congratulations for both of you, and thank you for Michelle and her husband. Thank you very much.
Hey Jennifer and Michael, congratulations. Very happy to be here. It's very exciting that you two found each other and that we have this wonderful place to celebrate your union. Cheers.
Hi, Jen and Michael. Congratulations on your upcoming wedding. And I hope that you live out here so that, Michael, we can use your services and, Jen, yours too. We need some more lawyers in our family. And if you wind up close to us, we can babysit. I'm ready for that.
very happy to have you all here, and Maria's sorry that she can't be here, the group's mother. But she wanted to extend to everybody.
She is very happy for Jennifer and Michael, and very happy for what you've brought to Michael's life. She appreciates that Jennifer has made a lot of sacrifices to go to Virginia and has suspended her, you know, in a way, her track of her life to help and support Michael in a time when he really needs it. So we also are very happy to have Jennifer in our lives. We see how much Michael and Jennifer love each other. It just takes a conversation on the phone that we've had with both of them to hear how collaborative they are, how supportive, how much they hear each other and listen to each other and support each other. So it's been wonderful to watch that. Also, the marriage to Michael is not just a marriage to Michael, it's a marriage to an entire family. One of the things that I've learned after 27 years is that one of the great things that I have been able to get from along with the deal is my husband's family. And it's one of the great treasures that I have. Cheers. It's one of the great treasures that I have is my husband's family. And it was a little rough going in the beginning. They didn't quite accept me in the beginning. They didn't think the marriage would last, actually. I don't know why, but they didn't.
Who said that?
A lot of people said that. But I found that. But I found that the things that I fell in love with Richard, I found bits and pieces of that in Richard's family as well, and fell in love with them as well. And you know, his mother, his father, his cousins, his aunts became mine. And so we hope that you come to know us and love us with all of the faults and the good characteristics that we may have, all of us. And we look forward to you joining our family. We're so happy for the wedding and just so pleased that you have taken us on. Cheers to taking
Cheers.
People on.
Cheers.
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 You mean so much to me. I've learned about you through doing this, and you know, our late calls when Michael's on call. And I know you're alone, and you're handling it beautifully with grace and poise. And I know you sacrificed your career for a while to make sure Michael gets ahead. And there are very few people that would do that, and it's so appreciated. And I totally understand how hard it is for you to do. That I want to thank you from the bottom of my heart for taking such good care of Michael. And I hope that one day you can see me as your second mom. Aww.
Thank you.
Okay. Bye, Marie.
Just getting rid of me.
Bye, Mija.
Well, I'll put you over here. You can eat
so
with
you
us.
Guys having
scarf on her. It was like a peasant, one of the peasant women from Russia.
The next question is, what is the bride's favorite artist? So one question is author, and then another question is artist. So there should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 opportunities. Okay.
All right.
These are the answers. Oh, wait, are we grading other people so we trade with a friend?
No, it's on the honor system. Okay. So grade yourself. Question number one is, what's the bride's favorite musical group? And it's Churches.
What?
Really? What
did I go to a concert?
From Lincoln Park.
Lincoln Park too.
Wait, you don't like Lincoln Park?
You're a liar.
You have their CDs. Come on, Cher.
Yeah, what have I listened to them?
What is the bride's favorite cocktail or drink? What do people think?
White Russian. Sparkling white wine bubbles.
Rose.
It was
Moscato.
What?
Just
really?
Like
the wines were
close. You guys like sweet wine.
What is the bride's favorite color?
Blue.
Yeah.
We all got it right.
The only one.
What is the bride's favorite weekend activity?
Computer gaming.
No!
Drawing/digital art.
Sleeping.
Walking her cat.
What? Did anybody say movie?
What?
No. I put not sure. I'm learning so much about you, Jennifer.
Okay, you don't know me.
It was movie.
Weekend?
You don't even know yourself.
What?
Sister.
You never told me about the movie one.
What?
Oh, wait, that's
not. I talked to you about
something. Okay, what is the bride's favorite movie?
The Notebook.
That's what I put too.
That's what I put down. That's definitely not it.
You were right. She said Amelie.
Wait, Amelie.
Oh, I remember. It would have been the Amelie one.
Yes, I remember.
She made you watch it. Doesn't that clue you in? Okay. What's her favorite author?
Jane Austen.
John Grisham.
Grisham?
I was thinking
of the politician.
Okay. The answer is Malcolm Gladwell.
Oh, I like him too.
The Brink. Tipping Point.
What's her name?
All my favorites.
Okay. Who is her favorite artist? Martha?
Van Gogh.
Close. Impressionist. What? Anybody know?
Oh, Salvatore Dali.
Ooh, kind of eclectic, edgy. I like that.
Rembrandt?
No. Oh.
Monet.
You can, yes. Okay. And then what is the bride's nickname?
Oh, cool.
Jen.
What?
Jen?
She said Fen.
Yeah!
Okay. Add it up. How many points do you have?
Got 2 points.
Zero.
Jen.
One, two,
three. Okay, so Jen is going to walk by you one
time. Maybe 3.5.
Whoa, what did Annie get?
Annie?
I passed out white wine bubbles. I feel like that counts as a
There's no bubbles in
this Annie, work it.
Otherwise, I got 3.
Okay.
If you don't count the Moscato one,
what
I got 3.
What did you get?
Anybody?
I got blue, Fen, and Monet.
Oh, Johnny. I only got blue and
brunette. There's a lot of things.
Okay, everybody cannot write anything
down. I don't
know.
I've only written one thing. I don't know what to
write. Are you guys ready? Nobody write anything down.
We can't write until she leaves.
Okay, ready?
No.
Okay, go.
Okay. Oh, shoot. Wow, girl. Wait.
Rock slower.
Maybe
shake less. Okay, wait, you gotta walk a little faster. Okay, don't walk so fast.
Oh,
this is
too fast.
Show your mom.
How many things are there?
Show your mom. Okay, now walk past. Okay, now show your mom and your aunt. Turn and show your mom and your aunt and Martha. Okay, now you gotta go.
This way.
And then go to the other side, though. Oh, they're not playing.
Oh, sorry.
Okay.
Bye,
all right, bye. Okay, and write them down.
The first mover's advantage here.
We're competitive in this family.
Oh, I forgot. Is that it?
Should I go?
Come on, write down. Everybody's pens down. Isabella, pens down.
Pen down.
Wait, wait.
Are you done?
Yeah.
Give me the pens.
Wait.
Okay. A crown. A strainer. A red measuring spoon. The number 5 candle. A little clip that has a number sign it. A horn. A avocado slicer.
I didn't even see that.
A spatula. A tea steeper.
Strainer.
Tongs. A spoon.
Bottle opener.
What do you call that?
Like a cookie cutter.
Cookie. No, it's not a cookie cutter. It's like a mold.
Mold. Cookie mold.
I take cookie cutter, a bottle opener, and another strainer. That doesn't help, right?
That's also a
and a pot holder.
If I only have one strainer, yes.
Okay, how many people? How many?
What is this?
Does a butter knife work? Did we say butter knife?
Oh, was there a butter knife?
There's a butter knife.
I got that.
Where's the butter knife?
Underneath the tongs.
Right. It's right here.
Oh, butter knife. Yeah. Butter
spoon. Or it could be a cheese knife.
And you got this. Oh, wait. And you got the New Year's crown?
Hold it up, baby. Hold
okay.
It.
How many?
Hold it, hold it.
Who has 10?
Wait.
10.
Wow. Good job.
10. I have 11.
Whoa. Whoa. That's 12.
Why aren't you playing?
Two tens?
I have 12. The tea strainer counts as both of them.
Yeah.
Oh, sure.
Wait, does the tea strainer times 2?
Yeah. Then I have 12.
This is not a tree tea strainer.
No, that is a strainer. We just call it strainer. I put strainer and then I put tea strainer. There's 2 tea strainers. One of them is
so how many do you have total?
I have 12, but it counts as 13.
All right. Okay.
Okay,
okay. And who has 12?
We have 12.
They
work
12.
Together.
Well,
then that
means
I have 12.
You have 12. Okay, so we have a 13 and a 12.
I'm not playing.
Okay,
13.
I should have been the one to parade around. It would have been much more successful.
What is it?
Yeah.
I like circling things.
By the about the couple. Ready? You guys ready? Where was their first date?
I know.
If I do it,
their first date. Where was their first date? Jen is like, you know. How did they meet? That's question number 2.
At an Olive Garden.
At an Olive Garden convention. Question number 3. What is the first thing that Jen cooked for Michael?
Jennifer cooks.
Which, yeah. Okay. Question number 4. What is Jen and Michael's favorite restaurant?
Olive Garden. Olive Garden, definitely.
What are Jen and question number 5. What are Jen and Michael's pets' names?
Serena knows
that. That I know.
Here, give me the pen.
I didn't know you had pets.
Oh, we have a cat and a hedgehog.
A hedgehog?
Yeah.
Isn't that really a pet?
In Virginia, it's okay. In California, they're illegal.
Okay.
Oh, well.
That's why you
gotta get it.
The one question guaranteed.
Question number 6. What does Michael do to show that he loves Jen? Keep it G-rated. Next question is, what is Jen's nickname for Michael? And then the last question is, what is Michael's nickname for Jen?
These are terrible answers.
The answer of the first date is Cataletos.
Wait, what?
Really? Cataletos.
Oh, here?
Yeah.
What's
Cataletos? They met here. The question answer to how did they meet? They met on OkCupid.
I guess.
I forgot online dating.
online.
I get that more right.
70%.
Question number 3. What is the first thing that Jen cooked for Michael? Is Thai curry.
What? Oh. It's a dumpling.
And I have to say, interesting, you had Thai food for the first course. Question number 4 is, what is their favorite restaurant? Is the Ranch.
Oh, I should have asked that. Yeah,
question number 5 is, what is your pet's name? And there, it's Clint Eastwood and Prince William.
Darn it!
You don't know the pet's name.
I put down Sir Humphrey.
Oh, Prince William.
Prince William.
I put Clint and Sir something.
Sir
Humphrey.
You can figure out
who
Prince William.
Excuse me. What does Michael do to show you he loves you? He will spontaneously cook breakfast.
I will cook!
And bring cookies and sweets.
I put flowers and hugs.
I said make food.
Oh, that's right then. You got that.
That counts. That counts.
All I do is bring a pebble.
What is Michael's nickname? What is the nickname that Jen calls Michael?
Michaelis.
Is it? Do you say BB? Bebe?
Bebe.
Bebe.
Oh, that was close.
And then Bebe. Jen's, Michael calls Jen Pookie.
Oh my gosh, that's so cute. I knew somebody called her something.
Okay, so who got six?
Damn it.
Right. So did she ask what Michael's nickname for Jen was?
4 right.
She got herself out of wrong.
3 right? 3 right? 2 right?
I think I might have
got 2
right. 2 right?
Not 1.5.
You got Pookie.
Dating up and
you can't play again.
Yay!
You
got Pookie.
Okay, yeah, you win. I put down Sir Humphrey.
I put Pookie for the wrong person.
Yay! Man, I should have known.
Interrogating about the pets got me somewhere.
I've heard Pookie, but I didn't know she was calling Pookie.
Sure, Prince William. We can split it up. By the numbers. So we'll make 2 games. This is Double Jeopardy, okay.
Oh.
What was the date of Michael and Jen's first date? And whoever's closest wins that. Yeah, gets the point. Question is, the greatest number of days that Jen and Michael have been apart. Okay. The number of days that Michael and Jen knew each other before they had their first kiss.
Half a day.
Half a day. A quarter. A decimal point.
That's a lot.
Months that Jen dated. Months that Jen dated Michael before Michael introduced her to his family. How many months?
0.1.
And how long before Jen cooked Michael a meal? I have a question about this, actually.
How many months?
Whoa.
How long did it take for Jen to cook Michael a meal? Because I saw the answer there that you sent me, and I couldn't believe it. And then months before Michael introduced Jen to his mom.
Wait, the family.
These are all numbers. These are all numbers.
Oh, wait, the family?
No, to his mom. Introduced Jen to Marie. No, wait. Michael to his, that you introduced Michael to your family, to your mom, sorry. All right. The answer to the first question is the first date was December 20, 2015.
I put March 1st.
I should have known that.
This is like 3 months.
That's a long time.
I say November 15, 2015.
Oh, that's close.
Oh,
I was home though.
Good. Okay, you're the closest, so give yourself that point. Okay? Greatest number of days they are apart?
100.
26. Greatest number?
30.
I think I should say, like, 18 and a half to become engaged, right? Or something like that.
Oh,
after they got engaged. Does anybody want to change their
acid days?
I feel
like
you
two
have
been apart all that
late.
What is it?
What do you got? Who has a lower number than?
I say 18.
You get the point.
When was that?
It was 10.
And what did she move on?
18.
I put down
14. You already won. You're disqualified anyway.
I'm disqualified?
Yeah. I mean, you don't get another prize. But you can still play.
Okay, she can have...
Okay, days they knew each other before they had their first kiss...
5 days.
That's what I
said.
7 days.
I said,
have to do it.
No.
Like
15
days.
Oh, we said 14.
15. It's 11. Oh, we said 14. Oh. We're close.
Oh, okay. 14. Okay, 14 is closer. Okay, 14. You get that point. She gets that point. Months they dated before Jen introduced Michael to her family.
No,
was
it was Marie.
3 months.
2 months.
2 months.
Four.
1 month.
Oh, really?
Wow, that's fast.
Yeah. Wait,
1 month?
Yeah,
I know.
Yeah,
no.
Wait, who put 2 months?
I put 8 months.
Now, Jen, the date at which you cooked him his first meal, you said March of 2018. That means you dated him for 3 years before you cooked him a meal.
No, 2 years.
Really?
I
couldn't believe it. I said, oh, she made a mistake. But it was, okay, look and learn,
you guys.
We put
December 12, 2018.
You did?
We thought they met in 2017, so our timeline was
wrong. You get it. You get it. Okay. You get it. Okay. And months before Michael introduced Jen to his mom was, I mean, it was less than a month, basically. So it's a month or less. And then the number of countries Jen has visited is 15.
Whoa, really?
We said 12.
I was trying.
Her sisters. Okay, so Canada, how much? Okay, here, how many did you get right?
Three.
Thailand.
Okay, we have three right. Ireland. How much did you guys get?
I only two.
Everything around Ireland because she went to study abroad.
Two. Anybody get more than two?
Wait, countries. I put six. Then two.
I put down eight.
No, no. How much total? How much did you guys?
I basically lost.
I put like one.
One.
We did it! Yay!
Thanks, okay, and who got two right? Who got two right? Who got two right? You got two right. Yes. Okay.
Thank you everybody for being here and celebrating this with me, and thank you Michelle and Richard for hosting.
And Marie,
thank you so much. This is a very, very nice gathering. I'm glad we could all get together.